Dear students, those who have appeared for the CSAT examination, prelims examination, let us have a brief analysis of the question paper with respect to English comprehensions. Okay, here at present, due to the availability of time, we shall have a brief discussion over here. And a detailed analysis most probably in the classroom very shortly, or in the next sessions we shall have a detailed discussions about all the paragraphs. My dear friends, let us begin with this particular paragraph which has appeared in your civil service examination, prelims examination. Okay, the paragraphs which were given this time, they were not simple. They require a lot of clear understanding, okay, and they contain lot of words where vocabulary is very important over here. Those who have taken pains, those who have worked hard, they have done it well. Okay, friends, here to begin with this particular paragraph, here he is speaking about how the denominations of religions, denomination of religions means dividing the religion based on caste, creed, people telling that my religion is good, your religion is okay, this, that and all. He has given a simple explanation over here that when people involve in religious discourse, when they try to criticize the other religion, when they speak bad about other religion, when they are not judging themselves properly with respect to a particular religion, there is a disturbance of unity. Unity goes away from the society over here. So here, my dear friends, the logical assumption after reading this particular passage should be, a small passage it is there, the logical assumption after reading this passage would be, men do not understand, he has given. Religions domination tend to ignore unity, he has given. It is the duty of everyone to propagate one's religion, has been given there. No man can live without adhering to some religions, he has given here. My dear friends, the right answer to this particular paragraph should be this one, option number 3. Option number 3 should be the right answer. C. Religious denominations tend to ignore the unity of man. When a man tries to, what do you say, denominate the religion, when he tries to speak about all superiority about religion, that what it creates, it tends to ignore the unity. So here, after reading this particular paragraph, your right answer should be option number C. Okay, friends, next one, let us go to the next part. Okay, in this particular passage, he has spoken about, it is certain that sedition was a contempt of breach of laws are not so much to be imputed to the wickedness of the subject. Here, when you read this paragraph, he is telling you again and again that here it is not the people of that particular country, but the sovereign that is creating the problems in the society. He has given a explanation about how the natural passions are everywhere the same. If wickedness more prevails and more offenses are committed in one commonwealth than in another, it is certain that the former has neither in neither than the former has neither enough pursued the end of that, therefore it has failed in the making quite good its right as a commonwealth. Here in this particular paragraph, he speaks about how the people are blamed, but actually that is not the case. Here the sovereign of that country, you know, that is the main factor which has been creating problems over here. And after that, he asks you which of the following is the most logical and rational inference that can be made from the passage given below. My dear friends, when you go through this passage, the rational and logical inference should be the option number second. Okay, should be the option number second, right? Okay, which is that option he has given here? This should be your right answer. Here, as I told you, it is not the people but the sovereign who is responsible for all the problems of any dominion. That should be your answer with respect to the question number second. Okay, so here in our next sessions, you know, we shall take up every paragraph and discuss that in detail. Okay, but now in order to give you the answers for all the passages, this is a brief session. Okay, right, next what it says, let us go to the next part. Right, next passage is about, in this particular paragraph, he is speaking about inequality. What are the problems created by inequality? Inequality, what does it violate? It violates the basic democratic norms and that, this and all he has told here. When you go through this paragraph, you know, you will come to know that here he wants to tell you is that equality is prerequisite. It is very much necessary for people to participate in the multiple transactions of society from a position of a confidence. That he has explained it here in the later parts. And here in this paragraph, he is also telling you that occurrence of inequality is detrimental to the survival of democracy. If the democracy has to exist there, if the democracy has to be present, you know, occurrence of inequality is detrimental. Detrimental means it is not going to be suitable for that. So when you are answering the questions given here, he asks you, what he has asked you is, he tells you that with reference to the above passage, the following assumptions have been made. Which are those assumptions that are correct? Okay, here in your options, as I told you, these two assumptions, they sound right. What about this one? Equal standing of citizens is an idea that cannot actually be realized even in a democracy. How it cannot be realized? This should be the wrong option. It is not right. Okay, first and second, as I told you, are present over there. Let us not put the into marker here. Right to equality should be incorporated in our values and day-to-day political vocabulary, he says that. So he has not mentioned about that anywhere in the paragraph, about right to equality should be incorporated in our values. Okay, and day-to-day political vocabulary. Okay, when you look at the options, the right options are 1 and 2. Okay, these two are related to the passage given below. So your right answer should be 1 and 2 only. 3 and 4 are not given in the passage or not relevant to that. Okay, then what he says, let us go back. Okay, go back to the next one. Here in this particular paragraph, he is speaking about the aristocratic government ruins itself. How? When a man takes the full power to control the country, single man rule, how it limits his powers. Then he says about oligarchy government. Okay, then he speaks about how the oligarchy also ruins itself. Okay, then incautious scrambles for immediate wealth, how people tend to take up the power and misuse that. Here, my dear students, in the entire paragraph, he is trying to tell you one fact. Okay, that reflects the crux of the passage. Crux means the central idea. So here, my dear friends, he goes on telling you The most important fact he wants to tell you over here in this passage is any form of government, whatever it may be, right? Okay, tends to deteriorate, okay, by excess of its basic principles. He has explained here that when it uses the basic principles to the excess, or when they are misusing the principles they have, when they move away from that, that is going to create a serious problem. Okay, by looking at the options here, human societies experiment with different form of government. This is not the right answer. Okay, right, this is not the right answer over here. Let me tell you. Okay, then what he says, any form of government tends to deteriorate by excess of its basic principles. This is what we have understood from the paragraph. Education to all citizens ensures a perfect, functional and sustainable democracy. That could also be taken into account, but here let us not put into mark over here. Then next one, having a government is a necessary evil. That says it is wrong. Okay, then here about education, what you have spoken here, to select the best ruler and the wisest courses, the people have no okay, before that, this is at first glance a delightful management. It becomes disastrous because the people are not properly equipped by education to select the best rulers. Okay, here education of all the citizens ensure a perfect, functional and sustainable democracy. My dear students, this is not mentioned anywhere in the paragraph. Okay, whereas again and again he tells you about any form of government tends to deteriorate by excess of its basic principles. So you can go with B as the right answer over here, because he has not given any other choices over there. Okay, so you can go with the option number B as your right answer. Friends, what is the next one? Here in this particular paragraph, he is speaking about the challenges that India is facing in the near future with respect to energy, climatic changes, policy making, and he has explained about the fossil fuel production capabilities, etc., and how these things are predicted over there in the near future and all. Here, you know, he has asked you a question. What is the critical message this passage gives you? So here, when you go through the entire paragraph, or in our future sessions, I shall go on discussing these each paragraph in detail in the classroom as well as in the offline classes. We shall have a thorough discussion over here. So in that particular passage, he is speaking about India's decision making process, okay, and he is speaking about it is more complex and it is interconnected with so many other series of issues over there. So by looking at the options, you know, you can go with the option number A. India's energy decision making process is ever more complex and interconnected. Ever more, it requires much concentration. Second point, he says that India's energy and climatic policies is heavily tuned to sustainable development. That is not given anywhere in the paragraph over there. Okay, just a minute, you can bank on that. Okay, take this option, have a question mark on that. Then India's energy and climatic actions are not compatible with its broader social, economic and environmental goals. He has not given there, you cannot draw an inference over there. Then he says that India's energy decisions making process is straightforward, supply oriented. That is not given in the paragraph. my dear friends, you can take up this one as the right answer. Which is the right answer? India's energy decision making process is ever more complex and interconnected. That should be your right answer for that particular question. Okay, what is the next one? He says, oh, this is a small paragraph. Here he is speaking about there are reports that some of the antibiotics sold in the market and fed to the poultry and all, speaking about medicine. Okay, this is about antibiotics as a growth promoters. How antibiotics are considered as a growth promoters? What are the different problems that are created by that? Okay, here how drugs are being promoted only by keeping in mind the profit perspectives, etc. Okay, so here it is an economy based passage. Okay, but still the question given here is very simple. Which one of the following statements best reflects the critical message conveyed by the passage? Okay, the critical message conveyed by the passage here is antibiotics should be used to treat diseases, not with respect to the other aspects. You know, people should avoid consuming the products of animals. How is it possible? Okay, foods of animal origin should be replaced with foods of plant origin. That is also not possible according to the passage. Using antibiotics on animals should be banned. How can you ban that? Okay, but you can consider option D as the right answer. That is the crux of the passage. That is the message conveyed by the passage. Okay, friends, what is the next one? Let us see. Let us have a look at that. Okay, what is the next one? This is also a very small paragraph. Okay, here in this paragraph he is speaking about the policy makers and media have placed the blame for skyrocketing food prices on a variety of factors including high fuel prices, bad weather in key food producing countries and the diversion of land to non-food production. Increased emphasis, however, has been placed on a surge in demand for food for the most, etc. Okay, here my dear friends, in the first three lines, policymakers and media have placed the blame for skyrocketing food prices on a variety of factors, which are those including high fuel prices, bad weather conditions, that, this and all. My dear students, all these are why they are, what has been made, or after reading this paragraph, you know, among the four options which you have attended, the first one is the following assumptions have been made. Which are those? Oil producing countries are one of the reasons for high food prices. Agreed. You can take that as your answer number one. Okay. Okay. Second one, if there is a food crisis in the world in the near future, it will be in the emerging economies. That is also to be considered. Okay. So here, your options should be both 1 and 2. These two should be your right answer. Okay, here next one, let us see what he says. Next one, the central message of modern development economies. Okay, here it is a fully economic based paragraph based on your GDP, how the changes are being made. He has given about the central message of modern development economies is the importance of economic growth, by which it meant growth in gross domestic product. In theory, the rising GDP creates employment and investment opportunities. As income grows in a country where the level of GDP was once low, household, communities and governments are increasingly able to set aside some funds for to make a good life over here. Okay, then today GDP as a production of things that makes for a good life assumed such a significant place in the development lexicon that if someone mentions economic growth, we know they mean GDP. Okay, According to this, my dear students, your options he has given here, this should be your right answer. Okay, one second, there is some problem over here. Okay, look here. By looking at the following questions, you know, he has given a question over here. With reference to the above passage, the following assumptions have been made. Okay, which are those assumptions? Rising GDP is essential for a country to be developed country. Okay, here he has used this word, rising GDP. Okay, do you feel it suitable? Rising GDP is essential, he has given here. Whereas in the second one, rising GDP guarantees a reasonable distribution of income to all households. This is clearly mentioned in the paragraph over there. Okay, so that should be your right answer. This one, rising GDP is essential for a country to be developed, is not related to that what he wants to tell you. Okay, next one, let us go back to the next part given here. This is about the fig trees are considered sacred in India. Okay, right, and East Asia and Africa are common in agriculture, urban landscape, weather trees are almost absent in natural forests. Fig trees provide food for wild animals and other resources. He has given a clear explanation about the use of these trees. Okay, then after reading the paragraph, he has again and again told you, trying to tell you, okay, what he is trying to tell you is, fig trees have a big role in the seed dispersal of other tree species. He has explained here in the paragraph. Then he also says that fig trees, you know, they can grow where other large woody species cannot grow. That is an additional advantage of that particular breed of trees. So by looking at this, you know, the right options should be option number second, once again, option number second, and this one, option number second should be right. Fig trees can grow where other woody trees cannot grow. And in the paragraph, he has also mentioned about the fig trees have a role in the seed dispersal of other tree species. So these two are looking as the right answer. Whereas fig trees can often be keystone species, he has not given there, in the forest. Okay, sacred trees can have a role in biodiversity conservations, that is not mentioned over here. So you can go with the option number 2 and 4 as your right answer. Okay, next one, he comes to the point that, okay, once again, what he says, next one, next paragraph, at the heart of archaeology is the idea that agroecosystem should mimic the biodiversity level over here. Okay, here, my dear friends, in this paragraph, he is speaking about the nutrient loops, that is, return of the nutrients back to the soil, from the soil to the plants and again back to the atmosphere and again going back to the soil. Okay, so how it is affecting the pest resistance, then closing in nutrient loops, he has explained, farmyard manure, how it is being applied, then he speaks about the soil fertility, etc. At the end of the paragraph, you know, he gives you some of the consider the following words, cover crops he has given, fertigation he has given, hydroponics he has given, mixed farming he speaks about, that polyculture is given there. So here, when you take these six words into consideration, he asks you a question over here. Which of these farming practices can be compatible with agroecology as implied by the passage. As implied by the passage, with respect to the passage, okay. So you can go with these options, okay. Option number one, cover crops, he has given that, okay. Then he has spoken about mixed farming, that is very much necessary. Then he speaks about polyculture in the given paragraph. By looking at these six options, you know, you can go with option number 1, option number 4 and option number 5. Therefore, your answer 1, 4 and 5 should be the right one with respect to the paragraph. Okay, so in our later classes and sessions, you know, we shall have a thorough discussion about about all these paragraphs one by one. Okay, then let me take you to the next paragraph. Okay, so what it says, which of the following practices, as I told you, 1, 4 and 5 should be the right answer. Okay, next one, he is speaking about the use of computers, how they are changing the present world. Okay, then he speaks about this is about computer science, how it has been changing the modern transactions. Okay, then the arrival of internet of things, we'll see that computers baked into everything, from road signs, MRIs. He is speaking about everywhere today they are replacing the human workforce. Okay, then what he says after that, question number the arrival, etc. Okay, the arrival of internet, he has spoken over here. Then at the end, you know, which of the following statements best reflects the most critical inference that can be made from the passage? After reading this passage, what do you understand with respect to this particular paragraph of computers? Is here he is telling you again and again that there should be some special laws, a strict law to, what do you say, with respect to the data security. Okay, lot you can hear lot of things that cyber crimes, that this and all. So here I would go with the option number 3 as the most critical inference with respect to this particular passage. Here he says that stringent data security laws are the need of the hour. Okay, he has given there clearly about how these things are misused, how people are trying to deceive others by the improper use. So you can go with C as your right answer. We shall have a discussion about that in our later classes. Okay, so what is the next one, friends? Next passage is about the social and physical environment, riddle with the poverty, inequalities, unhygiene. It's a general paragraph. He's speaking about so many problems over here. Then he says that scientific and micro level interventions are required, are not sufficient. They are not sufficient to bring down the burden of infectious diseases here. How these hygiene has been affected. Then in the paragraph, he is also telling you about it is the community hygiene implemented to public health measures that is really effective in battle against infectious disease. How you can overcome these diseases and all, he has given there. Okay, to begin with, let me show you the remaining part of this particular paragraph. Okay. What he has given here, but entry of market into this domain has created a false sense of security. He is simple, but understanding the basic theme is very important here. So he goes on telling you, and at the end, you know, he asks you, now on the basis of the passage given below, the following assumptions have been made. Okay, assumptions have been made, but which are the assumptions that are most valid, he asks you. Okay, so here, you know, you can go with the scientific micro level interventions are not sufficient to bring down the burden of the infectious disease. He has given there in the paragraph that just by scientific and micro level interventions, you cannot bring down the burden of infectious disease. Then he clearly tells you that it is the community hygiene that is very important. Hygiene implemented through public health measures, if you go through that, that is really effective in the battle against infectious diseases. You can go with the option number 4 and 5. Where has it been given? It is given here. That brings you to the assumptions. That is the assumption you can make out of that. Okay. And after that, what he says, when you go to the next part here, okay, this particular paragraph is speaking about the street lights. Okay, how their powerful light has been affecting the biodiversity of that area, how insects are being affected, how the how they are going to create an adverse effect on the ecosystem, and all he has given in this particular passage. It is about that intensity of the amber lights. Then he compares it with how they are reaction it is being created. So here after that, which of the following statements best reflects the most critical inference that can be made from the passage given below? Okay, he has given low intensity light has more adverse effect on the plants as compared to high intensity. That is not given in the paragraph. Okay, second one, light pollution can have a permanent adverse impact. He has given this particular part in the passage. Okay, adverse impact on the ecosystem, you can mark this. Okay, before going to the next one, let us see what are the other options they have given. Okay, what are the other options that I've given? White light is better for flowering of plants as compared to the light of other colors. He has not distinguished that or trying to explain it to you. Okay, that is not the right answer. Proper intensity of light in an ecosystem is important not only for plants but for animals too. Here about animals, plants, he has given the explanation that light pollution that is caused, it is can have a permanent adverse impact on the ecosystem as a whole. So you can go with only one, because he has given four options here, A, B, C and D. If you want to take up the right one, you can mark B as your right answer. That is the most logical thing present there. Okay, next one, my dear students, let us go to the next paragraph. What is that? Because of the time availability, I am telling you the answers at present. But in the future sessions, you know, we shall have a detailed discussion on that. Okay. So here he is speaking about, if you go on looking at the paragraph, many of them are based on agriculture, economy, the pollution levels and all. Okay. So next one, he says that this paragraph is about monoculture. Okay, how it can hamper, which of those, what it can do. Okay, so here in this particular paragraph, he has given that, he is trying to explain it to you that sustainable production of India cereal food grains is impossible without the diversity of pollinating animals. That is given there in the paragraph. Monoculture, he is speaking about it again and again, of horticultural crops hampers the survival of the forest over here. So here, my dear students, if you have marked this as your right answer, both 1 and 2 are most suitable with respect to the paragraph, then that is the right answer. Friends, okay, what is the next one? Let us go to the next part over here. Okay. Here in this particular paragraph, He speaks about the study conducted on the impact of climatic change over the Cauvery basins and all. Again, he is asking you a question over here. In this particular paragraph, you know, he about the whole paragraph, whole passage, what is it speaking about? It is speaking about the climatic changes increases the criticality of water resources while simultaneously threatening it. Okay, in the long run, it is going to threaten the environment. Okay, so here, my dear friends, when you look at that, so here you can go with, once again, you can go with, he has given you some options over here. Which one of the following statements best reflects the crux of the passage given above? Okay, here by looking at the whole paragraph, you can go with the option development of regional climate models helps in choosing climate. Okay, agreed. Heavy dependence on groundwater, that's not given here. Climatic changes increases the criticality of water resources, this is clearly given there. This should be your right answer with respect to that paragraphs. Okay, about the next paragraph, you know, he says that, okay, what is the next paragraph about? Here he is speaking about researchers, how they have been using the stem cells to gauge the neurotoxic effect of environment. He is speaking about that bisphenol BPA, they are, how they are going to be affected. Okay, what are the basic assumptions that can be made over here, my dear friends? The basic assumptions you can make here are, here biochemicals and cell-based assays are useful in finding out treatment for pollution, assays are useful in finding out treatments for pollution-induced diseases. This can be taken as one. And similarly, my dear friends, you can also go with option number 3 as your right answer over here. So your answer is 1 and 3 only. You can go with 1 and 3. That is wrong. One second. You can go with 2 and 3 as your right answer. This one should be your right answer. Option number 2 and 3 should be your right answer, because they are related to the paragraph. Okay, my dear friends. Okay, then my dear students, these answers, you know, they should be, these paragraphs should be discussed in details. Okay, in our next sessions, I would like to discuss with you some more paragraphs in detail. Because of the time constraint, I will just tell you the answer of the other two paragraphs. Okay, then what is the next one? Okay, he is speaking about, once again, let me show you. Here he is speaking about the medieval merchants risking their hazards and all. Okay, what are the options he has given here? He has, by looking at the following assumptions, he is trying to tell you that human beings are motivated to explore new frontiers principally by economic considerations. Please mark this as your right answer. See, so why it is right, what exactly was given there, we shall discuss in the classes. Okay, right friends, my dear students, the remaining discussions about these paragraphs I shall discuss with you in the following sessions. Till then, take care. God bless you. I shall meet you soon again. Thank you very much.